Alessia Cara paid homage to her biggest musical inspiration for Halloween this year. On Sunday, the 25-year-old Canadian singer shared on Instagram and Twitter of her costume, where she channeled the late Amy Winehouse in a perfect tribute. Cara fully nailed the look, weaving in some of Winehouse's signature looks and styles into the costume. She styled her hair into a beehive with some tousled curls loose, adorning her hair with a red bandana tied into a bow like the "You Know I'm No Good" singer wore regularly. The makeup was spot on with faux tattoos to match Winehouse, a dramatic cat-eye winged liner, bright red lipstick, and a beauty mark drawn on above her top lip. Amy carved pumpkin, the singer simply captioned the photo. Fans and fellow celebrities celebrated the singer's look, showering her with praise in the comments for emulating the late singer so well. "Perfect WTF, JoJo," whose real name is Joanna Levesque, commented. Natasha Bedingfield added, "So good. I had to double take. Nice," one fan wrote, with another adding, "You look just like her."
One user even commented, "Amy would be proud. Fire, 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 now that's some unholy war." Winehouse was found dead at her home in London on July 23, 2011 at age 27. The late singer died from accidental alcohol poisoning after resuming drinking following a period of abstinence. In the past, the here singer has opened up about her love for Winehouse and the impact that the late singer has had on her own music. She even covered some of Winehouse's music on her YouTube channel, including Valerie and a medley of Rehab, Back to Black, and You Know I'm No Good. In an interview with Bustle back in September, when she was asked who her current music idol was, Cara responded with Winehouse. "She is always going to be an idol of mine, continuously throughout my life," the singer responded. "I always look to her for musical guidance and lyrical guidance." In September 2020 for Rolling Stone, Cara ranked Winehouse's second and final studio album Back to Black at the top spot on her Greatest Albums of All Time list. The singer reflected on what Winehouse meant to her growing up, recalling the moment when she first saw the Rehab music video when she was 9 or 10 and how she was really captivated by her as a budding musician herself. "Amy Winehouse is one of the reasons that I wanted to become a musician in the first place," she said in part. "I remember watching her acoustic performances before she became, you know, Amy Winehouse. She was just up there with her guitar and she never sang the same way twice. That was something that I loved about her, that I'm still trying to do." Earlier this month, Cara discussed her love for Winehouse on a recent episode of Zane Lowe's Apple Music series At Home With on The Zane Lowe Show. She talked about getting to work with Salaam Remy at his Miami home where Winehouse wrote some of her Back to Black album, a story which she also told on an appearance on The Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon. "It was a full circle moment for the singer, who said she first found out who Remy was from reading the song credits in the booklets that came with her Winehouse CDs." The young singer also opened up about Winehouse, appreciating how unapologetically honest and raw and real the singer was. "I loved how open she was. I felt like I was always listening to a diary or something that I wasn't supposed to be seeing," she said. "And so I think just being in that space, it really like allowed me to tap into that in myself, into that unapologetic nature, and sort of say what I needed to say without worrying about the repercussions in a sense, and just letting go."
Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.